Hi everybody and welcome Shivani to BLCC. So glad to see you here. And today we're going to do a DIY. I'm going to tell you Shivani how to do the makeup. And Shivani, tell me, what is the first question on your mind?
So yeah, basically the first question comes in my mind. I guess everybody can connect with this. How to do get a perfect base for myself.
Sure. So Shivani, you know, a lot of people make the mistake of trying to check their base on their hand like this.
Yeah.
And the color of the hand and the face is very, very different. So also a lot of people have acne or dark circles, and when they do the base, after some time it starts to turn gray. I'm sure you've met a lot of people.
Yeah, I do have acne and everything.
Yeah, so we start with that.
Okay.
Yeah? Very gently. Just blend it in with a brush. Remember, it's not for the full face, it's only for the spot that you want to conceal. Now what I'm going to do is take your base and try it first on your forehead, right? And then see if it blends in.
Okay, so this orange one is for the acne and the dark circles.
Exactly.
Okay.
So the orange will go and cover the acne and the dark circle. And the rest of your complexion is very fair. You know? So you can see how this color is blending into your skin. Make sure it goes into the hairline, but it does not touch the hair.
Okay.
Because, you know, you must have seen a lot of people when they do makeup, you can see it on their hairline. Look up. Go as close as you can to your eyes and then move the brush either downwards or outwards. The base does not go on the eyelid because otherwise it will create a crease. So make sure this base is only for the face. Shivali, can you see a difference?
Yeah, definitely. It all covers up.
Yeah, the redness is gone.
Yeah.
But where the orange was, I'm going to use a little more base.
Okay.
So that the orange color does not remain there. So how quick is this?
Oh, very good.
And make sure you go down on the neck, because your face and your neck cannot be a different color. So when you're wearing your outfit, you know, it has to be till the neckline. Now we come to the second side of the face. Look up. So Shivali, how did you earlier choose your color?
Like, I'm the very, you know, non-makeup person.
Okay.
So I usually do like normal makeup. So I'm not into that much. But you know, I guess after today's session, I have learned so much.
And we just started.
Yeah.
So I guess it's not even 5 minutes, and your face is done. At least your base is done.
Yeah.
I must show you guys what brush I'm using. It's a flat base brush. I don't know if you got it, but
use the right brushes. You know, at VLCC, we're very particular about the brushes we use.
Okay.
Because the way you place a brush on the face is how it's going to make a difference to the way your base sets out or your eyeshadow sets out.
Brushes really makes a difference, right?
Yeah, so you must have the right brushes.
Okay.
Also, you know, you can, after the base is done, you can also use a little on the ear. Otherwise, in the pictures, you know, sometimes the ear is very different from the base that you've used on the face. Now the brush I'm going to use is this one. And this will blend in the base. It has circular movements. If you can see, I'm using circular movements. Look up. And I'm taking the base outwards.
Okay.
So it all blends in perfectly. Look up. After the base, we're going to use a bit of loose powder, white powder. Put it on your brush and brush it off. And then again, go circular motions on the face. You know, Shivali, why we use this powder? Because it seals the base. So if you do not, even if you touch your face or you're sweating or whatever, your base is sealed. It's not going to bleed. How's that?
It's like perfect. No acne, no dark circles, nothing.
Great. So what is our next step?
The next step is the eyes, I guess. The person, you know, first is the eye. So how can we do our eye, you know? So maybe a smoky eye we can try it.
Okay, I'm going to do, I'm going to give you a great tip for, you know, the easiest way to do your eye. And it requires only one pencil and it requires a brush. And that is the round brush. But what I'm going to do, Shivani, is I'm going to do one eye and I'm going to let you do the other eye. Are you ready for that?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so take a C from here. Make a inward C at the corner of your eye. Okay, and a outward C at the inner of your eye, and that is the best trick you can have for the best smoky eyes. Now take a round brush and start blending in circular motions towards the inside of the eye. Go halfway to the eye and blend it really well, but make sure it does not go on the top. Yeah, you know, this is the easiest and the fastest way to do your eyes. Pull it up from here how you would do when you're threading your eyes. Yeah. How does that look?
It's great, and it's very easy. And it seems very easy.
Yeah, it is very easy actually. So we'll just blend it in a little more. And especially people with big eyes, this works really well. If you have small eyes, then what you can do is you can create a round here with your circle and your eyes start to come out. So I'm going to give you the brush, Shivali, and let's see you do it now.
So let's try it. So we have to make a C over
here. I'll hold it for you since it's your first time, and you can hold it from the side.
Yeah.
Yeah. And make a C.
Okay.
See how easy is that?
Yeah.
And the inner. Yes. Perfect.
Now it's time to blend. So you have to blend like in a circular motion, right?
So inner circular motions, go round and round. And put the brush very gently on your eyelid.
Don't pull up the brush, just go circular motions. Should I hold it for you?
Yeah.
In circles. Yeah. And come aage, come towards the half of the eye. Yes. And now you can go to the inner circle. Shivali, for a first timer, I think it's amazing.
I think it's very easy, and slowly I'll become a perfect in that.
Yeah, if you do it like 2-3 times, yeah. I'll help you. Guys, if you do it 2-3 times and you practice it at home, I think it's very easy to learn. Right? Let the brush stay there and don't pick it up, and then go into circles. So put the brush here, place it here, and go into circles. And don't get impatient. So there, Shivani. We are done.
Yeah, it really looks pretty, and it's very, and very easy, guys.
And it's so soft, all you guys saw. It makes the eyes look so soft. The next is the mascara. So, the one thing about mascara, you know, it makes the eyes look beautiful. It's summertime, even if you're not doing any eye makeup and you're doing just mascara, it's going to be lovely. So, what you do is again, hold it from here, from the upper of your eyebrow. And go into zigzag motion to pull it up. Now I'm going to give you the same, and you do it for the other eye.
Yeah, sure.
You know, this is really exciting, because to see somebody learn in like 5 minutes is the best thing. Mascara a lot, because that came like really effortlessly to you.
Yeah.
And of course,
you actually glasses. You guys, you know, very, very easy steps, and it's very easy to use.
Okay, so next thing is use this brush. Okay, and it has a comb. So just comb out all the extra that could have been on the lash. Great. Now the next step is kajal. Okay. Do you put kajal, Shivali?
Yeah.
You do?
I use,
okay.
Yeah.
So now I'm going to show you a new way of putting kajal.
Okay.
Look up. Go into smaller strokes into the inner of your eye. I'm sure you got a lot of compliments on your eyes. Always,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, right.
Okay, now you can pull your eye lid up and look down and just touch a bit of kajal on this corner so your eyes look more defined.
Okay.
Yeah, see?
So you just use on the inner lid, huh?
Inner lid and then the upper corner lid.
Okay.
Okay? So like this, just touch it here and here.
Okay.
Okay, now try that one. Start, yeah. Start from here. Small, very small strokes. Pull it up from here.
That's right?
Yeah. That's it. Not on the lashes. Inside. On the inner lid. Yes. So, Shivali, you know what it does? It opens up your eyes, especially for people who have small eyes, and when they put kajal, the lower lid is very nicely defined, but the upper lid remains, you know, kind of the same, then it really opens up your eyes and it makes you look more expressive, right? Now the next thing we're going to do is your blush.
Okay.
Yeah?
So take a brush, that is a slanting brush, and now what you're going to do is measure from your little finger, from the start of your ear to here, where it ends, that's where your blusher should end. It should not be that your blusher is coming onto your cheeks and almost touching your nose, right?
So I'm going to use a soft pink color. And make sure it doesn't come onto your under eye. This part should not.
Looks really fresh and everything.
Yeah, it looks lovely.
Yeah.
So what I'm going to do, there are two brushes for blusher. One is the slant brush with which you start and one is the round brush, right, for the apple of your cheek. So let's start with the slant brush and the pink blusher, and you know how to measure it.
I guess I have no idea.
No, I told you the finger trick.
Yeah. This one.
Huh? Yeah, but with your little finger. Yeah, so it can't go beyond this because this is exactly where your cheekbone is also.
Okay.
So it has to go above that. With
you
that,
have to place your finger here and above the after of that, right?
Yeah.
Like there?
Yeah. Go ahead. No, you could use a little more. Makeup is that, you know, you can keep experimenting and trying, and don't be
scared to try out something new. Yeah. Yes. And now, this is your brush. And you have to smile when you do it.
Yeah.
And that's your color. Perfect. Okay, now what I'm going to do, Shivani, I'm going to touch your under eye a little bit more after the blush. With just the tip of my brush, I'm taking in color. Look up. And I'm taking it till your forehead, so it gives you a very defined look. Look up, please. So did you see? I created a line from here to here.
Okay.
Right? So you can do the same.
Sure.
Just the tip. Yeah, very little.
Because now your eyeshadow is much more defined and much more clean.
Okay.
Yeah? So that's why I always use it. This is one, another tip that I want.
Always touch your under eye again. From the tip of your brush, take it here and draw a straight line there. Okay, Shani, what is next? Yes, lips. And I think they're like really doing it quickly. Like it's happening before time, I think. Okay, so when we draw the lips, you know, generally we stretch it, and then women have a tendency to purse their lips, right? You put the lipstick and then you do this.
Yeah, but
never do that, okay. Because it draws a line here, right? So I'm going to do your lips. And one thing I want to tell you about lips is that they're most ignored. You know, generally they get really chapped and everything. So what you can do is you can use Vaseline, or you can use virgin coconut oil for your lips and your face at night. And when you get up in the morning,
it's really supple. Your skin, your lips, everything's really supple. So I'm going to start with your lower lip. Okay. Stretch your lip. So the lip line is generally darker than the rest of the lip color. Now stretch your upper lip. Is this how you do your lips? Pretty much, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, now you have to make a pout. So when you do a pout, if you have thin lips, you know, you create a better line for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And then you don't need to worry about the perfect shape. Because a pout is not just for posing for a selfie. It's also for using your lipstick to come out better. And always make an oval shape here instead of a pointed shape. It makes the face look softer. Pout again.
So guys, do pout when you apply lipstick next time.
And not just for Facebook
yeah.
selfies. Yeah. Okay, now we have this range of colors.
I'll suggest let's go a little peach because it's summers. So I'm going to give you this color on the brush. And since we've outlined it, would you like to draw it?
I have to just fill it. Fill it?
Yeah, just fill it in. Because the pencil has been drawn all
mm-hmm.
over, you know, you find it very easy to fill it in. Yeah. Now I'll finish the look. Make a pout again,
and don't do this. Don't make a better pout. Yeah.
Now again, what we're going to do is take the magic brush. And draw a line here. So your lips are better defined. Off the extra and just blend it in here.
some extra shine. Tap it on after you put it with the brush. See?
Yeah, shiny now.
Tap it on. And you get that extra glow.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So Shivani, did you notice we missed out on one thing? And that was your eyebrows. Yeah? So I'm going to do that now. Use a brush and brush it outwards. And then with the same brush, come down again. Yeah? You have very nice dark eyebrows. So you really won't have a problem in, you know.
Shaping them. Very nicely done.
Yeah, once you shape them,
okay. You take this one. Can everybody see the brush? Yeah? So take it. A little brown.
We are pretty much done. Okay. How do you like the look?
I very much like the look, and it's so simple and easy to done. And I have done almost everything. I'm going to apply my, you know, my all the shoots and everything.
Yeah, so we do a quick recap on that first.
Yes,
we use an orange if you have dark circles, if you have acne, if you have pits, you use an orange. If you have pale skin, go in for a pink undertone base.
Okay.
Yeah, and if there is too much redness, then go in for a green color. So these orange will cut black, and green will cut red, and pink will cut yellow. So that's how it would go, right? And guys, choose your base well. A lot of times when you go out there and you pick up your foundation, you know, it just makes all the difference if it's the right or the wrong one.
Yeah? Like in this case.
And what, you had some questions about brides to be.
Actually, yeah, I have many friends here who just get married.
Yeah.
And on the D-Day, they have the beautician and everything for, you know, for makeup and everything. But, you know, when they are going out for their honeymoons, so, you know, what they have, there are no beauticians over there. So, what, you know, their people, what they can look prettier, you know, when they wake up or when they go out. So, do you have any suggestions or any, you know, proper solution for that?
Yeah. So, for that, we have the best solution. You know, we do permanent eyebrows.
That's
and
great. Permanent one.
Yeah.
Because, you know, every girl needs something that is permanent.
Yes. So it is semi-permanent.
Okay.
It lasts for about 18 months.
Yeah, that works.
That works completely. It's 1.5 years. And we do lips.
Okay.
So you can add a pink color, pink tone to your lips. And what happens with that is that when you wake up in the morning, your eyebrows are done, your semi-permanent lashes, which we've done for you, are done. Your lips are pink, so you're anyways looking like a diva.
And that sounds so dreamy, and if that can be done, that's a really, really amazing thing.
Yeah, so I tell all my brides that with your pre-bridal packages, please start now including semi-permanent lips and semi-permanent lashes and eyebrows, because that has become such an important part, you know.
Exactly, yeah. And for girls, so it's like a necessary part.
It's very important. And, you know, a lot of girls have dark lips and they're always struggling to find the right color. So walk into any VLCC all over India, and we have this facility. So I think all the girls who are getting married in this year, and everybody who wants to change the color of their lips, like, now you don't need to worry. There's a, you know,
complete solution for that.
Complete solution for that. Also with the eyebrows, you know, a lot of girls struggle with, a lot of women after 35 onwards struggle with their eyebrows going light.
Yes.
So, you know, you can get your eyebrows done, and 18 months is a great time.
Actually, a very long time.
It's a very long time. And of course, you don't, if you have functions in the family and you're going to be putting lashes all the time and you don't want to do that, or maybe you can't go for getting your permanent lashes done, you know, for the party you can't get the lashes stuck, then go in for your permanent lashes. They last you for about 3 weeks. There's a touch up and then you can keep them on for 3 months. Okay. So that works really well.
And it sounds really well, guys.
Yeah, so do we have any questions coming in?
Yeah.
And do we... so Nancy's asking us what was applied under the eyes. And Nancy, we applied an orange color under the eyes because there were dark circles. And to conceal the dark circles, if you're going to use the same color that you are using for the rest of the face, your eyes are going to turn gray. So please, please use orange and then use your base color. That's how it will stay. And our next question, I think, is from Vrinda, and she wants to know which brands. Vrinda, you know, I use all the brands. VLCC, we have all the brands. And you pick up a brand that works best for your skin type. You know, but besides the brands and the makeup, keep your skin very exfoliated. Go in for regular, you know, facials or cleanups. Drink lots of water.
Water.
Yeah, how much water do you drink?
Very well.
No, so at least drink, you know, 3 to 4 liters.
Yeah.
And it always works. Vrinda, how to apply lashes? Well, you need to use a glue to apply lashes. And you can also, maybe in the next class, I can actually put the lashes and show. And you know, so you will know, but it's not very difficult, it's a matter of practice. I'm sure you'll learn it next time. Okay, so Saida is asking how to blend foundation. Saida, I'll tell you how to blend foundation is with this brush. It is a magic brush. So, you know, you can go into circular motions and very soft. It has to almost be like a feather touch. And you know, just move circular motions and your foundation will be blended very well. So any questions that you need to ask?
You can suggest, you know, like this is summer time, so what lip colors or, you know, what eyeshadow we can use?
So a lot of times, you know, people make this mistake of going like for the same color eyeshadow. Well, if you like it, it's great, but in summers it can be very loud. And everybody wants a very soft looking look, right?
Yeah.
So, and a very fresh look. So go light on the eyes and light on the lips, especially if you're going out in the day. And if you want to do smoky like we've done for her, it's a light brown color. So you can do that. Do whatever suits you best. And for more questions, you can log into VLCC, post your questions. We'll be really happy to answer. And walk into your VLCC centers now. Get your makeup trials done. And don't forget, you can change the color of your lips. You can change the shape of your eyebrows. You can do some semi-permanent lashes.
Yeah,
so go look like a diva.
Part.
Yeah. Guys, so we're signing off now. And bye-bye. And thank you so much, Shivali, for being
here.
It is great fun.
Same here. Bye-bye, guys.